Man, not too rough, man. Oh. Careful, man. Yeah, just be easy with your babies. Yeah, Kevin wants to drink milk. He's already grown up. Yeah. Yeah, right? What is it? Yeah, you're a wonderful mommy. Yeah. What is it? Are you hungry? Are you hungry? Chubby was laying on her tail after she drank milk. When she lay on her tail.
Segments, all of our businesses perform very well. We're seeing strong revenue growth, and you know that's supported by strong bottom line performance. So really pleased with the performance of the business and the outlook as we go forward.
It's early days, but you've launched something called Health Hubs in Houston, and they offer a lot more than flu shots. Can you explain what they offer and why you see this as the future health
care? Yeah. Oh, that would be sick. It looked like it was stuffed down on there.
And the need to meet people where they are, around their health needs, in the community, in the home, and to lay them upon their hand. So the Health Hub is that community destination where it's not just about their convenient health or beauty, personal care items. It's about health-related services, the role of the nurse practitioner in the med clinic, the role of the pharmacist, and Jack, as we look at some of the challenges that we face in healthcare today, it goes back to that point about consumerism and healthcare. And our belief is engaging people about their health and making health part of their regular routine, back to this meeting people where they are. We do that with the right products and services. We can improve
Chubby.
Reduce overall healthcare costs.
Chubby.
Jack, today, two-thirds of all Americans
have
diseases. It's those
chronic
diseases that account for 70-80% of healthcare costs, and yet we know those individuals are not achieving their best health outcome. We can make a difference. I'm a bricks and mortar drugstore, but you know, we can deliver to patients' homes, to their mailbox, to their office, you know, and those are all the things that we do right now. We have, it's called Simple Dose, where you know, we can deliver prescriptions for that very high dose. So, you know, we're
she's going, man.
Not to allow others to disrupt our business model.
There were some kind of definitive, finalized feeling that we all have. And even when we get to that point, though, once all the books are counted and codified, and we do it fairly. So hopefully, you know, we're down that road, and the opposition isn't making their irrational arguments. We shouldn't be trying to honestly count every vote. Hopefully, we can get to that point.
What we asked you to do for 4 years and you wouldn't do it, but we're supposed to.
Well, I think she's being.
You want to know the artist.
Chubby, what are you doing, Chubby?
Including the Moonshot Room. But the remarkable pavilions are in service of an ambitious mission. People can walk around and see artists and their works in all stages.
And we shouldn't be allowed to do that.
And efforts of Pennsylvania.